service of my neighbor draw me to become a more authentic Christian. Transform me. Holy Spirit, guide me. At the moment of my death, call me, that we, as church parish, may praise you with your angels and saints forever and ever. Amen. Please stand.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Let's pause and examine our conscience and ask Jesus for his pardon and his peace. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sin. Bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Melchizedek, king of Salem and priest of God Most High, met Abraham as he returned from his defeat of the kings and blessed him. And Abraham apportioned to him a tenth of everything. His name first means righteous king. And he was also king of Salem, that is, king of peace. Without father, mother, or ancestry, without beginning of days or end of life, thus made to resemble the Son of God, he remains a priest forever. It is even more obvious if another priest is raised up after the likeness of Melchizedek, who has become so not by a law expressed in a commandment concerning physical descent, but by the power of a life that cannot be destroyed. For it is testified, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool. You are priest forever, the line of Melchizedek. The scepter of your power, the Lord, will stretch forth from Zion. Rule in the midst of your enemies. You are priest forever, the line of Melchizedek. Yours is princely power in the day of your birth, in holy splendor. Before the day star, like the dew, I have begotten you. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord has sworn, and he will not repent. You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus preached the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people. Alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus entered the synagogue, and there was a man there who had a withered hand. They watched Jesus closely to see if he would cure him on the Sabbath, so that they might accuse him. He said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up here before us." Then he said to the Pharisees, "Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than do evil? To save life rather than to destroy it?" But they remained silent. Looking around at them with anger and grieved at the hardness of their heart, Jesus said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was restored. The Pharisees went out and immediately took counsel with the Herodians against him to put him to death. The Gospel of the Lord. Notice we have some new sanctuary furniture. This is our new pulpit. The microphone system has to be installed in the pulpit, and it just came in yesterday, so they didn't have time to do it yet. I think tomorrow they're going to try to do it. So that's the new main pulpit. This is the new commentator pulpit. That's the new credence table. There was a bar cart that was there before, so that went away. And then the final thing in the Mary Cove back there, we'll have an altar, and Mary, the Blessed Mother, will be on top of the little altar, and there will be some relics and on display in the altar, so that's coming. Thankful for everybody's support to be able to do that. The gospel today is Saint Mark. And it's a guy with a withered hand. And when I hear the word withered, it reminds me of a withered flower. Something that's withered is shriveled up and dying. And so Jesus can heal things that are shriveling up and dying. And in our world today, I think our country is withering. World, our community, our mental and emotional health many times is withering. And so Jesus has the power to bring life to the things that are withering. So if you can think of anything in your own life that you would say is kind of shriveling up and not having the fullness of life, if you can think of something in your own life, let's offer it up to God at Mass today and say, "God, this thing in my life, this part of my life, doesn't have the fullness of life that I desire. So we ask you to give it life and to ask you to bless our country today as new leadership takes place in Washington." So Jesus, help cure our witheredness.
this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You're indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.